Now, your 11 Insta-Weather PLUS forecast with Chief Meteorologist Tom Tasselmeyer.
It was a record-setting day all around the Mid-Atlantic and the Northeast. Up in Boston for the Boston Marathon, unusually warm, record-setting 87 degrees in Boston. Thankfully, when the wintering times were coming across the finish line in Boston, they had a little bit of a sea breeze, and east wind kept the finishing temperatures around noontime in the 60s and low 70s. But then in the afternoon, they popped to 87. Syracuse, New York, 90 degrees, 90 at BWI Marshall, 90 in Richmond. All across this area, it was very cold, but look to the north, or warm. Look at the north and west, 25 for the afternoon high at Marquette, Michigan, where it was snowing. And that's where the air will be coming from. So we do expect temperatures to cool off quite a bit the next few days. But there's the record 90. In fact, it tied the record set in 2002. And the normal high is only 65. Pollen count. We don't keep records here, but it was in the very high range for tree pollen, grass pollen, and weed pollen. The total count, 2150. That's the highest I can remember so far this spring on that pollen count. Now, changes are coming because there's a front. Just a little ragged line of scattered showers coming across Pennsylvania down through the mountains of Virginia and West Virginia. That's the cool front that'll be moving through overnight. And so temperatures that are quite mild now will start to cool off toward morning. It's 57 up at Cleveland, and that cooler air will start to come into the western suburbs by morning with partly cloudy skies to start our Tuesday. So the day starts with temperatures in the 60s, but it won't warm up much from there. West to northwest winds at 5 to 15. It's 78 at the airport right now, but again, 50s in Cleveland, dropping into the upper 40s around 50 where the Orioles are playing baseball in Chicago, and 26 at International Falls. So here comes the cool behind this front. As it moves off the coast, we'll see some cloudiness behind the front. That cloudiness combined with the northerly breeze will keep it cooler. Wednesday, the front still active to our south with a few showers across the lower part of the bay, and then dry weather expected for Thursday and Friday before perhaps a more substantial rain comes our way for the weekend. 70s tomorrow, so it's still above normal, but much cooler than today, and it'll be breezy with some clouds around, northwest winds gusting to 25. Winds will be strong enough on the bay for a small craft advisory, 2 to 3 foot waves, and those winds averaging 10 to 15 knots. The InstaWeather Plus 7-day forecast, and remember, it was summer-like 90 today, but tomorrow, low 70s, and Wednesday, low 60s. We have a 30% chance of showers on Wednesday, but that would be primarily to the south and east of Baltimore. Areas north and west don't have much of a chance of rain there. Dry weather on Thursday and Friday, partly cloudy skies, 60s and 70s for highs, 40s at night. And then the computer models are trying to produce a coastal storm for us. That could bring some rain in here Saturday afternoon, maybe mixed with a little thunder. And the potential is here for some moderate to heavy rain Saturday night into Sunday. We need the rain. We're running well below normal for the year now as far as precipitation. And that's the first significant rainmaker we've seen come our way, perhaps Saturday night into Sunday, with temperatures dropping back into the 60s early next week.